there's a real crowd, please. Small world, all the friends know of me. Young bull living like an old geese. Quick release the cash, watch it fall slowly. Frat girl still trying to get in. Haters mad for whatever reason.
Welcome to Demolition Ranch. It is good to be back. I'm glad you guys are here. And those who watch the Off the Ranch channel probably know I've been gone for over a week, so I haven't been able to make Demolition Ranch videos. I have been slacking on Vet Ranch videos as well. Off the Ranch has been thriving. Those who watch Off the Ranch also may notice that I have my old truck here. It still runs-ish. I have it because Mare has my new truck today because her car is in the shop. So I got the old girl out, got her started. All's good. Today, we're going to be doing a video that I've wanted to do for a really long time. I have a kayak right over there. I want to see if you can paddle a kayak without paddles. Say you're out in the wilderness, your paddle breaks. This is a survival situation now. How are you going to get to shore? All you have is a gun. So we all know that with every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. So when I fire a bullet, the gun kicks back, which kicks me back, which in turn should kick the yak back. And that's what we're gonna be testing today. This is a nice little area of the creek because the water's flowing over there, but then it hits this big wide spot and it really doesn't move very fast at all, especially over here. So I'm gonna set the kayak right here, shooting into that bank right there, and see if it pushes us backwards this way. Starting small first with a 9mm.
So I wanna be sitting totally still to make this test as scientific as possible. 9mm pistol. We are not moving forwards or backwards right now. We are moving backwards a little bit. Let's shoot the whole magazine. Look at that! We're cruising pretty good here.
Shoot the whole magazine.
Now we're getting caught in this current here. I don't think we're gonna make it all the way across with the 9mm.
Even one 9mm did move the kayak a little bit. It really didn't move much until I got the entire magazine fired through there. Let's try something a little bigger, like a 44 Magnum. Well, this should be good.
All right, we are sitting pretty dead still. 44 Magnum. Two got us moving pretty good. It's throwing so much mud back at me. So six shots out of the 44.
Push the boat about as fast as an entire magazine from the 9mm. Let's try something even bigger. That's a 9mm. That is a 44 Magnum. And this is a 30-30. Rifle cartridges have a lot more powder and therefore should put off a lot more energy and kick us back further. So we're gonna shoot my Henry 30-30 now.
We are fairly still. 30-30. That was definitely the biggest kick we've had so far out of one shot.
A full gun's worth of 30-30 moved the kayak a little bit more than a full gun's worth of 44 Magnum. 9, 44, 30-30. That's cute. 45-70 government. Come on, that would have been so cool if you would have just stood up. This is my Henry 45-70 government. Some people use the 45-70 to hunt elephants. So safe to say, it kicks. It's gonna kick me pretty hard, and therefore should move that little kayak.
All right, we are fairly still. Not really looking forward to shooting a whole gun's worth of 45-70. Oh yeah. Man, that's not fun at all. That has definitely pushed us further than any of the other cartridges.
I'm fine. Didn't hurt at all. 9, 44, 30-30. Big 45-70 government. But we can go bigger. 338 Lapua Magnum. Stand up. It's for a show. 338 Lapua Magnum. That is a big cartridge. We're shooting it out of my Armalite, but I actually have sort of an ulterior motive with this one. I think it will do less. We shot six out of the 4570, and that pushed us further than any have pushed us so far, and faster. And this is obviously a lot bigger. It's bigger around, and it has a bigger projectile, and it has a lot more powder in it. So it's gonna kick harder, but this Armalite has this insane muzzle brake on it, which really makes it not kick very much at all. So we're gonna be launching six shots out of this as well. So equal number of cartridges, more powder, more mass, more velocity, more energy out of that muzzle. But I think that the muzzle brake is gonna totally tame it down, because that lever action had no muzzle brake, just a flat barrel, comes straight out the end. This one is made to not recoil very much. So the gas comes out of here and then it diverts backwards. We'll see. Have you ever seen a man fire a giant sniper rifle out of a kayak? You haven't? Well, you won't be able to say that tomorrow.
Just going fishing, no big deal. You gotta admit, this looks pretty cool. 338 Lapua Magnum. Moving pretty good. That's definitely a new record. We haven't moved that fast yet.
Those who frequent Demolition Ranch, you guys know what's coming next. You guys know that a 338, psh, that's for little girls to play with. Real men play with 50 BMG. Look at the difference there. I mean, these were jumping up a little bit. Look at that. That is a big difference. That's a very, very large round out of a very, very large gun, which will be really fun to try to hold on a kayak.
Y'all ready for this? Here we go, 50 BMG.
I have one more thing I want to try, and I think it's going to be pretty cool. But first, I need to thank my sponsor, Audible.com. They support us so that we can do stuff like this, buying expensive ammo out here. Otherwise, my wife would not be very happy when I came out to Demolition Ranch. I was like, hey, babe, I just got to buy some 338, some 50, some 4570. No biggie. We don't need food for the kids this week, you know? I'm reading a book called The War That Ended Peace by Margaret Macmillan. It is a story about the time in Europe leading up to World War I. And I first kind of got interested in that because I bought that 9mm Luger and started looking at books about World War I, which I'd never read any before. And it's pretty interesting. And I need to make a Luger video, by the way. If you guys have anything you want to see done with a Luger, let me know. But if you would like to read this book or any of Audible's other titles, use the URL right here, audible.com/demoranch, and you get a free 30-day trial to check out a book. So what I want to do now, what I've noticed, when you shoot one, it pushes you a little bit. When you shoot several in a row, all of those add together. So it pushes it a lot further. It's like if you shoot six bullets, it's like one bullet would be six times as powerful. So what my plan is now is to shoot a bunch of bullets in a row and see how fast it pushes the boat. I brought an AK-47 out here. 60 rounds, 7.62 by 39. This is gonna be so cool.
Giddy up, partners.
Turns out it's pretty easy to paddle a boat as long as you fire more than one shot. Huge video coming next. We have a gun safe that we're gonna destroy. We're gonna try to destroy. The company sent it to me because they think it's indestructible. Well, at least they think I won't be able to get into it. We'll see about that. Have a happy Thanksgiving. Have a safe Thanksgiving. Thanks for watching Demolition Ranch, and I will see you next time.
Contact!
That's a great idea.
What about the quad hog?
Don't move.
Bobby!